very much, Gorilla Monsoon. Now, as you wrestling fans know, many, many superstars right here in the World Wrestling Federation, many, many different reasons that they emerge victorious week in and week out in their various matches. But certainly there continues to be a great deal of talk, Mr. Fuji, if you will, of the mind-to-mind communication between you and your man, Magnificent Morocco.
The secret, boy son, ancient art secret, mind-to-mind communication, great wave vibes, good vibration, boy son, and also sick vibration comes out too.
I can believe that. Now, Magnificent Morocco, if we could, before we talk about one man in particular, that being Paul Orndorff, Mr. Fuji, a lot of talk still circulating about your escapades, we shall say, in Fuji Vice, and I wonder if I might query what might be coming out next from the dramatic endeavors of you and Magnificent Morocco.
I have Magnificent want to explain this. This is his topic. He love it.
All
he
right, Magnificent.
You got it right. It's topical, not tropical.
I better thought it. No, my.
It was tropical. You heard the joke was Ferdinand Marcos, Ronald Reagan, and Mikhail Gorbachev were stranded on an island, and they only had the plane was crashing, and they only had one parachute. You see, and there was Ronald Reagan said, I should have it because I'm the oldest. Gorbachev said, I should have it because I'm the leader of a powerful country. Now, wait a second, that's not the punchline. Ferdinand Marcos said, we should put this to a vote. Marcos won 94-2. Get it? That's what we got coming after Fuji Vice. We have humor. We have delight. We have talent. We have pathos. We have emotion. We have everything. And we have Mr. Wonderful. Isn't he wonderful? The man who stands there with the washboard abdominals and the washboard brain.
Well, it seems Magnificent Morocco and Mr. Fuji have appropriately used up enough time so as not to talk about Mr. Wonderful. We'll be back right after this.